So if you haven't heard yet, Google Photos storage is changing. Starting on June 1st, next year, 2021, any new photos and videos you upload will count towards the free 15 gigabytes of storage that comes with every Google account. But wait, don't freak out. In today's video, we're going to go over what this means and also a few recommendations to maintaining your Google Photos. We're also going to recommend a few alternatives for those who want to jump ship. If you're new here, please do hit subscribe. It'd be great to have you in the community. So if you don't know already, your Google account storage is shared with Drive, Gmail, and Photos. So the news is basically, any photo you've uploaded from now until next June 1st, you will be able to keep inside of your Google Photos account. Anything after that is part of your Google One account storage limits. So there's a few things you can do from this. The first is checking an estimate of how much photo storage you have been using. There's a little feature which will help tell you how much space you will take up with your Google One account. This is quite helpful to determine whether you need a pay plan or not. Google actually say that 80% of people will be able to still use Google Photos for 3 more years worth of memories with that free 15 gigabytes of storage. So that's a little bit of a mind rest for a lot of people. The second thing you can do is use the clean abilities. Now you're probably wondering, what are these tools? These tools help you to review the memories you have and help you delete them. And there's also recommendations like dark and blurry photos or large videos to help remove large amounts of storage. And the third thing you can do is actually buy a Google Pixel. Now, if you actually have a Google Pixel from 1 to 5, any photos uploaded from those devices are actually exempt. If you upload in high quality from those devices, you'll be able to continue even past June 1st, 2021. So the actual storage limits don't matter to you. So that is actually one of the options. Of course, if you do not want to do any of these for hassle reasons, or you'd like to continue to use Google Photos and appreciate the service, there is a 100 gigabyte storage plan, which should do you well, with $1.99 per month being the fee. Now, if you wanted to pay annually, it's $19.99. And for all of the features that Google Photos offer, it's not a bad bet. But I can imagine a lot of you going, I'm really angry, let me move all of my photos, or maybe even continue to upload any new photos from June 1st on another platform. Amazon Prime actually offers something called Amazon Photos as part of the subscription package. You can actually upload any unlimited photos in full resolution with up to 5 family members in a vault. So this is perfect if you want to continue your plan and, I guess, get what you had with Google Photos before with Amazon. If you are looking for a paid solution, Flickr actually offers. If you don't remember Flickr, it's a photo sharing application. It has a subscription service called Flickr Pro. At $60 a year, you can upload as limited photos, as many as you like across a year. Dropbox Plus actually have a plan after their 2 gigabytes free called the Plus plan, which is $119.98 per year, but offers you secure ways to upload your photos through camera uploads, which is something they offer through their app. So if you want a reliable name, Dropbox is a pretty decent bet. But as you can imagine, if you're someone that's already using Google Photos pretty lightly, but to securely your photos, then this is going to continue. And do remember, they'll uphold their commitment not to use information in Google Photos for advertising purposes. So big news from Google Photos, but calm down, guys. It's going to be okay. You can still use Google Photos onwards. Just remember, it from June 1st next year, it will go towards your Google One limits. So hopefully that calmed you down and gave you a few alternatives. If you are new here, please do subscribe. It'd be fantastic to have you. We do tons of productivity updates and, as you can imagine, helps you to learn tools and software. Thank you very much, folks. Have a great day.